Hello, and welcome to TI's Troubleshooting Tips series. Keep in mind, when working with and troubleshooting all TI components, it's important to reference ti.com/troubleshooting. In today's video, we're going to cover flux contamination, how to detect it, and how to inspect for it. Flux can manifest itself in different ways at the system level. Some examples you may run into are increased or decreased output voltages, an incorrect reading from an ADC, or a false measurement from a sensor. Detecting and looking for flux on your board can save you time and troubleshooting later on. Before we begin, let's talk about how to look for flux on a board and what it is. Flux can impact an application in various different ways. As mentioned previously, some examples can be effects on electrical measurement accuracy. This can occur due to the introduction of various different parasitic electric paths created by the flux. In addition, we can see flux impacting our mechanical components such as switches, MEMS devices, and the overall assembly of a printed circuit board over time. In addition, solder flux can introduce conductive paths between nearby traces, resulting in potential damage to the circuitry. Now that I've shown you the impact flux has on an application, let's look at ways to inspect and detect flux on a printed circuit board. In this live example, we'll make use of a low power optical microscope. However, it is also possible to use an optical lens, which is connected to a computer utilizing a USB connection. As shown here from the optical lens, we see browning from the solder flux between pins and electrical traces. This browning can result in an increase in the number of electrical paths between traces and pins affecting electrical measurements. In addition, we see solder flux around the package body and solder shorts between pins. The solder shorts can result in electrical damage to the component and potentially impact the reliability of the integrated circuit. Now that we've gone through the live example, let's continue and discuss how this can affect the application from a schematic perspective. An ideal op-amp circuit would be designed as shown in the figure. However, in reality, there are actually extra circuit elements known as parasitics. In the following figure, we see how this may be represented. Circuit components like resistors, capacitors, and inductors can add to the number of traces on our circuit. However, cold solder joints and contamination can further increase the number of circuit paths we may see on a real-world schematic. Therefore, it's extremely important to inspect for assembly-level anomalies such as flux contamination and cold solder joints to limit the number of parasitic paths we may encounter. A lot of these issues can be resolved through an ABA swap. On the following slide, we show the effects solder flux has on a printed circuit board. This example looks at the amount of voltage error we find doing a DC measurement. These errors can be random in nature and unpredictable, and issues like cold solder joints and flux contamination have this type of effect on our circuits. In the following figure, we show three waveforms from various levels of cleaning. The red waveform shows no clean, while the gray and blue waveforms show different levels of cleaning. As you can see, the overall DC error added to our waveform is changed based on the level of solder flux left on the board. Therefore, completion of a thorough cleaning and solder flux inspection post ABA swap process can help reduce the overall amount of error we may see in our applications. It's important to remember, when troubleshooting TI components, additional technical collateral can be found on TI.com. As shown on the slide, we see that there is TI's quality policies and processes on TI.com/quality, TI's E2E support forum, and TI Precision Labs. In addition, TI provides free simulation software for download known as TINA TI. Thank you for watching TI's Troubleshooting Tips series on solder flux contamination. For additional training content, please visit ti.com/troubleshooting.